As the Philippine government mulls whether it will mandate all schools to resume full face-to-face classes next month, a wind engineer has come up with a way to ensure the safety of the back-to-school process. Joshua Agar of the University of the Philippines, in collaboration with the Aral Filipinas Coalition, has developed a calculator that measures the risk level of COVID transmission inside classrooms. This is by way of ventilation. Engineer Agar and Aral Filipinas Coalition's Reg Sibal joins us this morning for more on this. Good morning, Engineer Joshua. Welcome back. And hi, Reg.
Engineer Joshua, welcome back.
Good morning.
Good morning.
All right. So first off, Engineer, let's start with you. Tell us about how this works in the first place. What exactly does it measure?
It measures two things. So first is the rate of ventilation. It tells whether the place is well ventilated or not. And second is the degree of COVID-19 risk. So your probability of infection and also the reproduction number.
Mm-hmm. And how exactly does this do it?
Within the calculator, you have to input first the dimensions of the room. Then you'll be plugging in, for example, the rate of ventilation. For example, if your windows are open, there are suggested values there. If there are additional ventilation, for example, if you're going to put extra electric fans that would serve as exhaust fans, blowing air out of the window, or exhaust fans in general. If you're going to put, for example, air purifiers, everything is considered, and also what kind of mask are you using. So within the calculator, you'll be inputting the what mask that you're wearing. So for example, no mask or cloth mask, then surgical mask, then KN95 mask and N95 mask. Then it will then finally the number of infected. For example, if there are asymptomatic, symptomatic, then it will actually return to you the degree of risk for COVID-19.
Mm-hmm, right. So it takes into consideration all of these factors before giving you results. And Reg, so this collaboration with Aral Filipinas Coalition, that you're a multi-sectoral network advocating safe school reopening, right? On the Safe Schools Calculator, how did this project come to be?
Well, first of all, the Aral Filipinas Coalition has always been keen on supporting efforts for learning continuity. We know that any stoppage in school results a lot in terms of learner, not just for the economy and all of those things, but also for the learners themselves. So any effort to help promote safe schools is something that we are supporting. And in this collaboration, we kind of got in touch with Engineer Agar to look at what mechanisms are being overlooked in terms of providing safety for the schools. And knowing that COVID-19 is airborne, realize a need to focus on ventilation. I mean, not to undermine the efforts of our that have been taken. We've already done sanitation and all of those things. But what's still missing from the picture to help prevent this and to help the schools, in using layman's term, Engineer Agar mentioned that there are some mechanisms that cannot be quantified. I mean, if we use the DOH numbers, that's a very technical term. So how do we make this into layman's terms so that the teacher, the parents may be able to understand, using certain data, that what factors affect transmission and how can we minimize transmission and how can we make sure that their schools have these safeguards. And given this, I mean, it's not just computing if a room is well ventilated or children or teachers are at risk, but it also gives you an eyesight of what, or rather a hindsight of what affects transmission, like as Professor Agar said, the number of fans, the windows, all of these come into play, and you will see that into how it affects the ventilation and the risk in terms of figures in the calculator. But because, as we said, we are all for helping any tool. I mean, this is not to end the COVID, but to help prevent. And by the way, the calculator can be recalibrated in the future, not just for COVID, but also for other airborne diseases. For now, it's calibrated for COVID, but of course, moving forward, we know we hope that there would not be anything else to put things at risk, but the calculator can be adjusted for other airborne diseases. And all of this is an to support minimizing school closures and supporting teachers into understanding how they can be agents of prevention of COVID, especially now that schools are reopening and then schools are opening and closing here and there, because if one is reported transmitting COVID, then it again closes the schools. So all of this is about prevention.
All right, let's go back to more details on that. First, Engineer Joshua, talk to us about engineering controls and administrative controls. What are the differences? And how would this impact the resulting calculation?
What are the differences?
Everything is preceded with communication. So this tool precisely communicates that inhalation of the SARS-CoV-2 laden aerosols would result to infection. So what your goal with the engineering controls is to reduce the concentration of those aerosols. So it engineering controls composed of the following. So ventilation, which you are replacing the used air within the room with fresh air coming from outside. So to introduce ventilation into the room, you either open your windows or you allow wind to come into your room, or you mechanically facilitate the exchange of indoor air without their air with exhaust fans or fans in general, standing fans that act as exhaust fans. And there's also filtration. So your end goal basically is to reduce the concentration of aerosols that you might be inhaling. So therefore, your risk of infection will be lessened.
Mm-hmm. And I like how accessible this is, right? It's a downloadable thing via a link. So it's Safe Schools Calculator. Where exactly do we find this, and what data or information is needed to make this work from the teacher's end or from the general public's end? Can this also be used for home, Reg?
For home?
Yes, we have made the for people who are asking, the calculator is not for sale. It is for free, so it is accessible. I think we can provide the link to those who are interested, or you may email us at rlpinas2020@gmail.com. We will provide you with the link and also resources. We're also trying to develop some videos with Professor Agar on how to use this, on how the teachers can maximize the tool, how they can plug in the values. And by the way, this is not just for schools. I mean, we've also tried others who are interested, who are from the from the corporate sector or the private sector, who are interested to use it, because other than the schools, this is also applicable to offices and other spaces or indoor spaces. That it helps make assurances to the public on the safety level of schools. Like you can put, if it's there are two things that you can consider there. If it's a poorly or ventilated area, but it doesn't necessarily mean that there is a sky. But plugging in other factors, as Professor Joshua said, like the mask and all of these things, allow us also to look at. Another is, of course, considering that this is public, but we're also advocating that it can be adapted. We hope that it can also be adapted by some by the schools, because we know that, as we said, we're providing this for free, and some schools and teachers may not understand certain technicalities in DOH and DepEd requirements. And so this will make it easier for them. And we also hope that it can help us also promote this to the public and also to the schools, and also perhaps later on to some offices to really advocate for the use of this. Again, this is not not for sale. This is all already accessible for the public. Feel free to provide you with the link. Send us by give us an email, or we can Professor Agar has always been very gracious to also post this in his social media accounts. Perhaps you can also look into the Aral Pilipinas Facebook page. We'll try to post also the links to this Safe Schools Calculator.
All right, on that note, thank you so much for joining us this morning, Reg, Engineer Joshua, you stay safe and looking forward to the more things that this app of yours could do for us. Thank you.